Rich people, stop discovering poor people food. I'm gonna make you mine. There's something special about your love. I think it's one of a kind. It's a beautiful day. Check it out. Isn't that beautiful? We are hitting the road. We're gonna be doing some wholesale pickups as well as some regular grocery shopping. Taking the whole family. Normally, I'll try to do like grocery shopping and stuff like that by myself, but today it's an outing for us all. We might grab some lunch, might grab some dinner. Just stay tuned. There's gonna be fun.
All right, so what's up, my people? If you hear the trains in the background, that's actually Kellan on the iPad right now. So what did we learn today? I am gonna be walking around BJ's for a little bit. When I say a little bit, I mean the Jamaican little bit. So what happened is we learned a valuable lesson that we all already knew, which is don't procrastinate. Don't put off things. Make sure that you just deal with things when you get the chance to, because they will catch up to you, especially when you're dealing with your motor vehicle. So I know I'm kind of alluding to it. I'll tell you what happened. We've been getting in the car for the last maybe about week and a half, 2 weeks. And we don't drive the SUV all the time. Mostly we drive the other car. What happened is we get in the car and there's like a whistling sound that goes along with the acceleration. Please, my mechanics or my mechanically inclined people, go ahead and comment below if you know exactly what's going on with the car. Car has been making this whistling sound with the acceleration and slowly starting to feel like it has to try a little harder to accelerate. Finally today, and the last time that we drove it, I said I need to carry it up to my mechanic. Didn't do that, and we drove it up pretty much almost in my mechanic's neighborhood, like maybe about 4 miles away or something like that, and the car started to sputter and still making that sound, and we finally got a check engine light. So Lisa is now on the way to go pick up the car. That wasn't my first choice. My first choice was for her to stay here in the store and for me to go with the stranger them in the Uber. But it was a whole thing even to talk Lisa into doing that in the first place. I think she's a little bit worried about the car and just it throwing off the original plan of the day. And of course she is trying to get Kellan on a schedule, so, and this is going to throw that off, because we plan to just do 2 pickups and turned into this like eventful kind of thing right now. So me and Kellan are in the store. Lisa has gone in the Uber to go pick up the car right now, and that's where we find ourselves now. I just kind of entertain myself walking around the store doing some window shopping and stuff, because we did have a pickup and there was just like one extra item that we're gonna pick up. I think also, you know, obviously the worrying about how much the car is going to be, kind of don't want to do leisure shopping when you know that there's going to be a mechanic bill. I'm hoping it's nothing serious. I'm hoping it's just like some kind of hose leak or something, that maybe there's like a hose that need to replace, something like that. But we'll see. We will see what the verdict is. Keep us in your thoughts. Meantime, we get to peruse through BJ's because we have quite a bit of time. I'm also going to miss my Champions League match. I'll just follow that on my phone or whatever, and also try to listen out for the tow truck. Luckily we have roadside service with our insurance, and it's within the 20 miles, so nothing out of pocket to at least get it up to my mechanic. So that's good. In the meantime, let's take a trip around the store, shall we? I'm loading up the car to go. So the driver same thing, it might be a cylinder thing. Yo, I don't know nothing about mechanics, so the man I speak German to me at this point. I just hope it's not gonna be expensive.
I do notice like a faint white smoke now and a odor. So, yikes. Yikes. Let's hope everything is everything, but I'm going to go talk to him right now, give him the mechanic's phone number just in case, and the name of the place to make sure it goes to the right spot. And then obviously when my mechanic gets it, I'll probably hear from him tomorrow on what's going on with it. Again, keep us in your thoughts and your prayers, because can't afford no care problems right now. We're still waiting on Lisa. Not sure if she even reached at this point. I'm not rushing her. It's quite a distance. Plus, you know, you have to go down there and come all the way back up and thing. But meanwhile, we're just going to chill out. Maybe just go and walk through the stores, I guess. Some leisure shopping, I guess. Funny enough, so a while ago, I was updating you guys as the car was being pulled off. Tow truck driver was like, must have hear me talking to you guys and hear the accent. And it was like, yo, you have a blog? And one thing lead to the next. We got a new follower. So shout out to your driver. Bless up. Yardman link. One follower at a time. Remember, like if you like. But if you really want to show some love, hit that sub and hit that bell as well. Cause we have adventures like these. Planned and not planned. Kellan is slowly starting to wear down now. We're in Ross right now. I'm going to take a quick spin around here. Nothing else to do but wait until Lisa comes back and hope that she has a safe trip on her side. See you guys soon. All right, so continuing the eventfulness of the day, we ended up eating at a restaurant we wanted to try for a while. Definitely wasn't planning on trying it, but the good news is Kellan, my little road man, was with me, but look who's with me now. So yeah, Lisa is here. We're gonna try this restaurant out. I'm gonna try to call back the mechanic and see at least that he got the car. And I'll let you know how the food is when we get it. In the meantime, check out the restaurant. Orange peel in there, so they did it properly.
Is that a thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a great smell to it too. You actually smell orange peel. That's a big man drink.
You know what that means? When he says a big man drink, it means it's strong.
Not only that it's strong, there's also like this weird like, it's gonna sound disgusting when I describe it this way, but like an old man musk too.
Let me tell you, whenever he uses like old man musk thing, it just makes me, it just sounds
it doesn't,
like.
It doesn't remind me of, it instantly remind me of his grandfather. Thank you so much. Yeah, instantly drinking this, it does remind me of my grandfather, so big up Ferdy. Lisa says hers tastes amazing, so that is a nice way of saying she thinks hers tastes better than mine. I'm gonna tell you, Lisa's tastes good.
Tastes amazing.
Tastes better than mine. But what's crazy is mine smells better, but hers tastes better. That's awesome. It's like the right balance of
like just a slight sweet, not like that overly sweet, trashy like chick drinks. It's really good. It's really, really good. Whoever's at the bar, shout out to your bartender. Big up, cause you do a good thing over there. You're doing the Lord's work over there, cause we need some drinks right now. The chicken is looking amazing. Yeah, so that Korean barbecue looks amazing. They look like they learned that firsthand from the GIs that came over and taught them from World War II. It looks excellent. So, yeah, I'm gonna try those in a second. They literally say it's KFC. Yo, it smells amazing. It smells amazing.
What you said?
All right, so I do want to say this though. In defense of the beef, I don't say that I like the chicken balls better than the beef, but the chicken one is amazing.
Amazing.
I think because I know that I have the KFC wings, I kind of feel like I could have done maybe the beef bowl.
This is the.
But man, the breading.
Crispy skin, yeah. Mike, it's like, nope, yay. Nope, I'm gonna go this way. Where are you going? It's another day football practice. I think we have one more session after this. Last week was supposed to be the last session, but then because of the hurricane and our coaches weren't here one weekend, we're doing like two makeup weekends. I know I'm really excited because I know like he's gonna get his medal and the certificate of participation and all that stuff. It's gonna be his first, so I'm really happy about that. It is hot, it's a hot day, but not like extremely hot because there's like a nice little breeze. Kellen is doing a really great job today. He's doing a lot of kicking, he's excited. It's a much smaller class than before. By maybe six students today. When they first started, they're about like 10 to 12. So a lot of people have kind of trickled away because their kids are not into it or just like other responsibilities, you know, it's life. But I think the smaller group he kind of likes better. So it's a much better day, you know. Like I said, in the beginning, things can be a little rough because you're like, you want them to like something or they're afraid because they've never like experienced it. And it really just takes dedication and continued like practice, even when your kid is crying.
All right, no hands, no hands.
Your feet.
No manos.
Even Kelly.
Come on, come on, Cody. Oh, no tripping, no tripping. That's a foul. That's a foul.
all the moms are just relaxed, chilling.
All right, so we're on the way back from football with Kellen. We did really good today, and we saw a Jamaican flag on the roadside here, 1792. Not sure if we will be out here all the time. I don't know, $25 for two plates between a curry goat and also a jerk chicken. We're going to try sample and support.
Auntie Ruby could come up here, you know, do something like this, she would do.
How did I get Auntie Ruby a food truck? So yeah, as you hear us talking, Auntie Ruby, if you're watching, more than this, we would definitely support. But we do want to support again from a city Jamaican flag. Why people stay so though? Like, the funny thing was, so nobody was there. Like, we never see him with nobody around. Then we stop. Then out of nowhere, magically, another van stop and a man just come. And he must say, yo, for him and him dad, him want a food. And then another brother wave pass and look like them was going to stop.
Then another one stopped and then didn't come out. But they were
okay,
I'll come back.
Other people eating food, you know what I mean? So I'm glad that we could at least get him some business started and stuff. Hopefully, food is good. The chicken did look good. The curry, like I said, everybody curry always look a little different and stuff. So hoping that the curry is good. We went with the curry instead of the oxtail. I think oxtail, from it gets so expensive, everybody does get kind of turning up their nose at it funny enough. Not because he had a bad price on it, but just because now I feel like because it gets so expensive, for people to do it now, they're taking even lesser quality meat, which is funny because that's how oxtail already came about. Rich people, stop discovering poor people food and then making it unaffordable. Low people food. You're all welcome to have food. Obviously, we didn't invent the tail of the cow, but you know, although I will debate, fight your tooth and nail, the whole oxtails.
It's
drives me crazy.
It's one tail.
Yeah.
Chopped up into pieces. It's probably a bunch of different cows' tails in one pot.
Yeah.
But it's one tail. It's one tail. If that piece sticking on one tail. Oxtails.
Oxtails. Yeah, if you're right, oxtails with an S on it, like I already know automatically, you've already said it's not Jamaican.
Jamaican restaurant and seen oxtails on it. And
no, from your seat. There's two things Jamaican restaurants can do that can make you know the right off rip them not authentic.
Okay.
For one, if you have to put Jamaican patty on there, you're not already it will
no,
have
no,
lost
no,
you.
That's not it.
I'm not going to be totally ignorant. I understand the whole argument that happened in Canada with the whole Jamaican beef patty versus patty and whatever. So I understand that.
Yeah.
But if you're in a Jamaican establishment and you're already in there and it has Jamaican patty on there.
Next one. Give me another one.
The oxtails.
No. If they say chicken curry, they're not.
Oh, yeah. But that's, yeah. Chicken curry, one. Hands down, if it's a chicken curry, we know it's from somewhere else.
I'm not used to growing up. And
which is not meaning that it's bad, because other people make chicken curry,
not.
But
I'm just not saying it's not a Jamaican.
Yeah, you're not Jamaican if you put that.
I've seen this, and I just, like I said, I never grew up seeing this, is oxtail stew.
Yeah, that's another one.
Right?
That's more of a like, I feel like it's Jamaican people like trying to explain to non-Jamaicans what oxtail,
it's like brown,
the way we
like,
make it is.
Think about it, it is oxtail.
The stew will
it's
make
a
pass.
Brown stew yeah. Of oxtail. So yeah.
I'll make this the oxtail stew pass. But the oxtails is unforgivable. You lost your Jamaican card.
Okay, it's a very little piece of meat. This is my hand. Very small portions. Rice and peas looks good. Oxtail, like Dan was saying, looks different than I guess what we're used to. We're used to a more darker brown kind of thing. Pasta salad is good. You know, usually they give like a cabbage salad, so that's good to see. The chicken looks small, you know, small pieces, like a small chicken, you know, this chicken like tiny. But definitely smells good.
Good people.
Good people!
Yo.
So I'm going to cook some brunch right now. I'm debating back and forth between, went and got this lemon thing there. I'm like, yo, kind of want that French toast, but I'm gonna be able to make the pancakes because we've been trying to make the pancakes for like literally a couple of days.
Make two French toast.
But all right, so what's the plan? Are we doing the chicken pancakes? It is. Lisa is going to make the chicken tenders for our buttermilk pancakes and chicken and French toast. Yeah, we're overdoing it. We're ODing, but it is what it is. It's gonna be like a Sunday brunch, kind of lazy brunch kind of day. Maybe even, hell, depending on if the bugs will allow us to get away with it, we might even go outside and eat on the fire pit table and just relax and have a good day. Maybe, just maybe, even turn on the TV and watch a movie. Maybe we might try to get away with one of those. We're gonna be drinking this, which we discovered on our hurricane trip. Funny enough, like I was telling you, with Lisa, both of us don't really like the normal one, but the rosé one was really good. So we're gonna use this with the freshly squeezed orange juice that we got from Sam's Club. I make some mimosas, fancy them up with some raspberries Lisa just bought.
Can't forget the Sam's Club fresh squeezed orange juice.
That's gonna be the Sunday vibes. Mimosa time.
This is how I like it.
Cheers. Love and blessings.
So the anniversary is strong.
5 years.
Of marriage.
Of marriage. How many together?
Maths is not my strong suit, you know. Alright, let's do 7 to the 20 and then what? 2. 9 years.
Yes! Good
December
job.
December make 9 years.
Cheers, guys. So this is called Before and After, apparently. I've never heard that term.
I told Lisa to turn on the camera quick because I don't know, the way we're too hungry right now, I don't know if you guys are going to get that glorious shot of the food when it's on the plate.
I tried to do a jerk buttermilk chicken tenders. I made like a jerk maple syrup. You can see the flavors. Flavors!
Alright, so this is the finished product. There's the egg. There's the pancakes. And then here is the star of the plate. The chicken tenders as well as the jerk maple. And we're still sipping on mimosas. We still have about a little bit, about like a half a bottle leaf. We're still thoroughly enjoying this Sunday. We're about to actually turn on like a movie or something and watch. Sorry, but Kellen probably will wake up right about now, but that not really going to stop nothing. We can watch, you know, part of the movie while him play around and stuff. So, see you guys when the plates are empty, maybe.
I think it's one of a kind. There's something special about your love. I want it all the time. You will always be my inspiration.